see what's going on here. Assalamu alaikum everyone. Samir, this is the reaction back with other reaction. You love it, smash a button, subscribe, the notification on. This means a lot to me. يعني الكثير لي. يعني so much to me. It is mean so much to me. That's what I'm saying here. So I come in, why Indonesia is always erupting. I have no idea what's going on, what erupting is. Burkan, in Arabic you say Burkan. يخرج منه الفح. Something like this. My name is Samir, I'm from Algeria, North Africa, between Morocco and Tunisia. Google it, you will know it. And my Twitter, my Instagram, it is here for me, for human lovers. I like it. And let's start with erupting. I have no idea, but let's see what's going on and let's check it together. Right now, 3, 2, 1, it is coming right now. Okay.
These are all of the volcanoes in the world. You've got this big strip here in Ethiopia, a big cluster up in Iceland, and a long strip down the west coast of the Americas. But there's one spot that has more volcanoes than anywhere else on Earth, right here in Indonesia. And it's not even all of Indonesia, it's a country of 17,000 islands. It's really this right here. This is called the Sunda Arc. And it's where the majority of volcanic activity in Indonesia is happening. It's where the violence, the intensity, the beauty of all of these blasts is taking place. I want to show you some of the most striking volcanoes on Earth. And I'm doing this because I want to try to better understand why they are so deadly and why millions of people live right in the shadow of these sleeping dragons.
Wow. Sleeping dragons.
Okay, let's quickly go over why volcanoes exist. Maybe you've heard this before, but I'm going to try to explain it in a way that makes sense. It's important to remember that the ground under your feet is actually a giant plate, 100 kilometers thick, one of many plates floating around on molten lava. They're all moving in certain directions and at different speeds. There are 7 main plates on Earth. And a bunch of smaller ones, and they're always moving. When these plates move into each other, they make mountains. When they spread apart, they make underwater volcanoes that cool and turn into rocks, and we call them islands. When they slide against each other, they make terrible earthquakes. And when they run into each other and one gets forced below the other, they make volcanoes. So the real reason why this one strip of land in Indonesia has so many volcanoes is because this plate is slamming into this plate at a rate of 7 centimeters a year, which is one of the fastest movements of plates in the world. So you're getting a ton of this, which results in a ton of this.
Ooh.
If you zoom into one of these volcanoes, you're going to see a lot of this dark green around the volcano where no one lives. But all of this, each one of these little dots are villages where tons of people live, and they're right in the strike zone of this volcano. Volcanoes kill people when they suddenly erupt, but it's not the lava that kills them, it's the ash. This huge column of ash and gases first goes up, and then it eventually falls down. As it falls, it gains momentum on these steep mountainsides, and eventually that will slam into villages. Up to 3 kilometers in radius from the volcano. If you were standing in the way of one of these massive ash avalanches, you will die. And then if it rains, it gets really bad because the ash and the rain make these horrifying mud rivers that cut through the mountains and flood villages all around the region. Before we go any further, I want to thank today's sponsor, which is Morning Brew. Morning Brew is a free daily newsletter, Monday through Sunday. I love Morning Brew because it is a great way to start your day. I used to start my mornings just sort of like rolling over, opening my phone, and wandering through several apps, not really knowing what I should be reading. Morning Brew is a clear, concise, and honestly witty and fun to read newsletter that focuses you on the relevant news in everything from tech to business to what's happening in the world. One of the things I've been following is the cryptocurrency world, and obviously they made a video about NFTs. They're witty, they're asking the right questions. It's just a really nice solid breakdown that's fun and very quick and easy to read. Again, there's nothing to sell here. Morning Brew is a free newsletter. It takes 15 seconds to sign up. There's a link in my description. Clicking that link helps support this channel, but it also allows you to sign up for this awesome newsletter. For 5 minutes a day, you're getting smarter and more informed about today's news. Thank you, Morning Brew, for sponsoring this video. And let's get back to volcanoes.
Volcanoes, yes.
And I want to show you some of the most striking volcanoes along this strip. And in the process, explain how and why humans live so close to these sleeping dragons.
Sleeping dragons. He's find his name of volcanoes.
Blew up really bad 3,000 years ago and left a 1 kilometer wide crater that is now full of this bright blue, very acidic water, the most acidic lake on Earth. Because under the surface, there is a huge deposit of sulfuric gas that is venting out of this crack in the Earth. All of this sulfuric gas means that when this thing erupts with lava, it burns that gas and ignites it in this mesmerizing blue flame. All of this gas also means that there is some money to be made. The locals have installed these ceramic pipes to catch the gases and force it to condense into a liquid. It flows down here to where it cools and turns into a solid, which can be harvested by locals. My friend Christian is there right now, covering the reality of this job. I'm gonna let him show you what this work is actually like.
Hey Johnny, so right now we are inside of Kawa Ijen, a active volcano, and this crater is full of life. You can see all the steam rising off of the water, this insane plume of yellow smoke. And this yellow smoke is what creates the sulfur. And with me here are the badass, hardworking dudes. No other way to put it. They're literal superheroes. This here is Supano. What's up, Supano? I've had this amazing opportunity to just pick his brain, try to understand a little bit better why is it that these guys have taking on some of the most challenging work conditions on planet Earth. What is the heaviest weight that you'll take up the hill?
75 kilograms.
75 kilograms. I just tried 40. Could barely manage it. I mean, you look at these guys. They're not bodybuilders, but they're strong-minded. They're incredibly driven, and they've got a good purpose for it.
How much money for 1 kilo? Only 1,250.
So how much do you make at the end of the day?
Okay. 300,000.
If you were to convert that to US dollars, that's about $22-$21 for the entire day's worth of work.
Wow. Wow. Fast money.
They sell this
and danger.
Which mainly uses it to bleach sugar so that it's white. It's backbreaking, dangerous work. Christian made a whole video from this mine and the realities of this work. I will link to that in the description. Next up, we have Mount Merapi, or Fire Mountain. This volcano has killed more humans than any other. It erupts all of the time, like every few years. Here it is erupting just last year. This thing is happening over the course of 5 minutes. This time lapse was recorded by Volcano UT and Freck on two different YouTube channels that I'll link to in the description. The reason why this volcano is so deadly is because, like I said before, there are millions of people living around it, and not just remotely around it, like right up against the mountain. Here's the volcano, and these are all the villages right up against it. Which raises an important question I had going into this story, which is, why do so many people live here? Like, so many people. The answer is that this is an amazing place to live. Indonesia has mild, warm weather. It rains super hard for a few months, and that rain is effectively stored in these mountains. And it provides water to these people throughout the year. And then there's the fact that this is perfect fertilizer. All mashed up and broken down, ready to make this soil.
It's an amazing place, yo. Every place in Indonesia.
We get amazing harvests from this soil every year because the soil is like magic. So yeah, the people living here are sort of in a high risk, high reward situation. They live on a sleeping dragon that could wipe them out at any time. And yet, as long as it doesn't, they have some of the best weather and growing conditions on Earth.
Yeah.
Next up is Krakatoa. What you're looking at here is actually a graveyard of what used to be a big island. It used to look a lot more like this, but 100 years ago, it blew up. We think this is the most explosive volcano in modern history. 10% of the world could hear the blast. It was so intense. Tens of thousands were killed in the ash. And the ash exploded so high into the air that all the way in Europe, the sky was red and hazy, which has led some to speculate that it was this event that inspired the red, hazy look of this painting, one of the most famous paintings in the world, called The Scream. The volcano that grew out of Krakatoa has kept erupting over the years, breaking this island down further and further until the whole thing just eventually collapsed and caused a huge tsunami that killed hundreds just a couple of years ago. The island went from looking like this to this, and today it's one of the fastest growing volcanoes in the world and will certainly be back for more destruction. Okay, the last one I want to talk about is this set of volcanoes. This one is Mount Bromo, and this one is Mount Semeru. First off, these two volcanoes are some of the most stunning volcanoes I've ever seen in my life. But they also represent the deep religious symbolism that volcanoes have come to symbolize over time. This mountain, Mount Semeru, is named after the mythical Mount Meru, which is a sacred five-peak mountain in the cosmology of three religions, Hindu, Jain, and Buddhism. It is considered to be the center of the physical and metaphysical and spiritual universes. The neighboring volcano is also deeply symbolic. It's called Bromo, which in Javanese is the name for Brahma, or the Hindu god of creation. Every year, Hindus hike up this mountain and make an offering of vegetables.
Listen to man walking in jail.
There are so many more volcanoes in Indonesia, and my goal is to go to Indonesia with my camera and actually photograph them for myself. A lot of the footage from this video came from Christian, who gave me a lot of his footage. He lives in Indonesia and from other places. I didn't go there, but I really want to. I'm now deeply fascinated with volcanoes because I've been deeply diving into plate tectonics. So I hope you understand more about why volcanoes exist, why so many exist in Indonesia, and how do people cope living next to these ticking time bombs?
Because it is an amazing place.
The giver gives abundance and fertility most of the time. But sometimes it chooses to take away.
Okay. Yeah. Wow. Thank you for information. This I never know about volcano stuff, and I never hear about like Indonesia having volcano and many people like die there and something like this, and I have no idea. Just now I know. So Indonesia lovers, smash a button, subscribe, turn notification on, give me love, that's all I need. Any reaction video, any reaction next, what you want me to react next, suggesting, this means a lot to me, in a comment, in a like, in smash a button, subscribe button, and this means amazing, and see you in the next video, inshallah, peace, love, salamu alaikum everyone, see ya.